you have been meeting people, what have they been asking you about the most? What have they been most excited to talk to you about?
I think probably mostly Star Wars, quite a lot of Game of Thrones, but interestingly some other things, quite a number about Hamlet that I did at the RSC, and sometimes people come up with things I did 20 years ago, Morse or cloning of Joanna May or something like that, so that's been nice, yeah.
Let's start with Star Wars. Of course, I mean, one of the biggest, if not the biggest, film franchises of all time. How did it feel to be even just a small part of such a fantastic series?
Well, it felt very surprising. I got it, in fact, because I was doing a play with Ian McDiarmid, who, of course, is all in all of them. And the American casting director came to see it and thought, oh, he might do for C.O. Bibble. And I went to see, I had this interview with George Lucas, and when my daughter was seven, I was at Stratford acting, and I took her to Coventry, and I think three times we saw The Return of the Jedi. So when I had my interview with George Lucas, I proved to know a great deal about The Return of the Jedi. I was an expert on Jedi the Hutt and all this kind of thing. And I think he was so amazed that this aging British character actor knew all about The Return of the Jedi that he gave me the job.
What do you think the magic of Star Wars is? Why do you think it's a series that, I mean, we're going to get episode 7 now and the promise of many more films to come. Why do people love this universe and these characters so much?
Well, I think he was very clever to put it long, long ago in a galaxy far, far away is clever. But I think what is particularly unusual is the mixture of human, half-human, animal and robot all coexisting with one another. And I think that was a very interesting concept, and I think appeals to people a lot. He also, of course, rifled Greek legend for good stories. So there are very, very basic quest stories in it, which have a universal appeal, I think. Yeah.
Talking about universal appeal, of course, you had the pleasure of working with the mercurial young Natalie Portman. Yes. What was that experience like, and what was she like when the Queen Amidala mask came off?
Yeah, well, I did work with Natalie, and she was probably only about 19 then, so she was quite young and shy, and very sort of intent and all that kind of thing. One of her, she had these decoy queens when she was playing Padme, and one of them, who was 12, had a long conversation with, because we had a scene together walking down the stairs, and we found out we both lived in Twickenham, and my daughter had been to Twickenham Comprehensive. Anyway, we had a long conversation about the relative merits of Twickenham Comprehensives, and this was Keira Knightley. Yes, age 12, that's right.
Obviously, that's a fantastic experience. Are there any other Star Wars memories that you're especially fond of, either being on set or since the films have come out?
I think I was very, very thrilled at Leavesden Aerodrome once. I was in a dressing room between Frank Oz and Samuel Jackson. I thought, yeah, that's it. Yes, I'd like that.
You know, you've really made it.
Yes.
I mean, talking about making things, I mean, obviously you mentioned Game of Thrones, of course, another huge global phenomenon. Yeah. I guess the first question, why do you think that, as a television series, has captured people's imagination so intensely?
Very interesting that sort of medieval fantasy has captured people. Well, it obviously is a great release for people to look at a different kind of universe, particularly in a time of recession. That maybe has helped. But also I think fantasy is on the move. People may have got a bit tired of the future of science fiction and so have transferred themselves to a more medieval fantasy. It's interesting, isn't it? But also it is in the whole world of Lord of the Rings. It creates its own world, doesn't it? And people get very taken up with the maps and the geography of it all. Yeah.
It's a very complex world, even for fans of the show to follow. Can you maybe just tell us where you fitted into the complex world of Game of Thrones? Tell us a bit about your character.
Well, I can't tell you a lot about how I fitted in because I haven't read the books. But my character upheld the old gods, and this young priestess arrives who's trying to transfer them to the new gods. So I started off series 2 on the beach with the old gods in flames. And I was trying to persuade Stephen Delane as the king to go back to the old gods. And I decided the only way to get rid of this beautiful young priestess was to poison her and me. So I proceed to do this, and she agrees to drink a loving cup with me, and we both drink. And I die, and she doesn't, you see. And I said to her in between takes, I'm not quite up to speed on this. Why don't you die? And she said, I'm 400 years old. And I said, oh, well, fair enough, if you're 400 years old. Should have checked on that first, you know.
You can handle your poison at that age, of course. I mean, I guess fans, of course, have their favourite characters on the show. Are there any other characters apart from your own that you're especially fond of or enjoy watching?
No, I don't think so. I mean, I'm very taken up by a lot of them, really, yes. Yeah. I always like Charles Dance, who's an old friend of mine, yeah. And Stephen Delane's a very good actor, as is Liam Cunningham, I was working with, yeah.
We're going to let you get back to fans here today, but my final question for young fans watching this who'd love to follow in your luminous footsteps and be a professional actor of stage and screen themselves, is there any advice you'd give them from your laudable career?
Oh, gosh. Well, I mean, work. You have to work hard at being an actor. Movement and voice exercises are terribly helpful. Even in doing film, voice exercises are useful. You know, there's a lot of luck. There's a lot of knowing people. All of that is true. It's really keep at it and hang in there. Hang in there as much as you can, even if you have to take spare time jobs. And, you know, the wheel of fortune will come your way.